So I'm kind of old school, got a journalism degree, been writing all my life, I've written all these books. So when I correspond, even if it's by text message, I like to write with full words, complete sentences, punctuation, everything. But I do see value in using emoji every once in a while. The problem is there's so many different little symbols that you can use, it's really hard to know what each one means, what it's for. And there's so many that look the same. So for instance, if I was to want to write a message or respond to somebody here, I can click on my Mac on the little smiley face button there and I get a list of emoji. And it's a huge, huge list. And I can look at it in groups. Like for instance, I can look at just the faces. I could look at animals. I can look at all sorts of different symbols, sports things, lots of different things here. But still, trying to figure out which one to use in a situation is tough. But your Mac actually makes it easy for you not only to figure out which one to use, but to kind of learn more about them. And the key is when you bring up this list here, you can scroll down a little bit and you have this search field at the top. So since these are symbols, what do you search for? Well, you search for words. And you can discover emoji based on that. So for instance, say you want to express to somebody that you're sad. You can just type in the search field sad and you'll come up with emoji here that have something to do with being sad. So I can roll over, put my cursor over each symbol after that and see that this emoji is supposed to be loudly crying face. This one is weary face. This one sad pensive face. And you can go through each one of these to figure out which one it is that you want to use. So for instance, maybe I want to use crying face here. I click on it and there I get the symbol. Using the search technique and then looking at the rollover text is the best way to figure things out. But you have to sometimes try several times. Like for instance, if I want to express that I'm angry about something, I may type mad and get a lot of stuff here. It doesn't seem to work really well. But if I type the word angry, now I've zeroed in on ones that will really work well for it. Here's another example of why you need to search around. If you look for nervous, you're not going to come up with anything. Anxious actually comes up with one. Worry comes up with nothing, but worried comes up with several that are appropriate for what I'm looking for. And you can see it's kind of interesting that in this case it's not even looking at the titles. So you can see the titles of these faces are not featuring the word worried at all except this last one. But yet it still comes up with these, which might be the appropriate thing you're looking for. So just keep trying until you get the hang of what you want and what you frequently use, and use it as a way to learn and also as a way to maybe find that perfect emoji for a situation.